Welcome to this presentation on research resources for psychology from the Webster University Library on the home campus in St. Louis, Missouri. My name is Kathy Gaynor, and I'm the library's liaison to the psychology department. Please feel free to get in touch with me if I can be of assistance to you as you go through your psychology program here at Webster. In this presentation, we'll look at the types of resources used for many of your assignments and how to get started with research. I'll also cover how to obtain materials from the library and get assistance if you have any questions or encounter any difficulties. In the past, you may have learned about primary and secondary sources. Primary sources are usually defined as first-hand accounts or materials produced at the time of an event. Often we think of things such as old diaries, newspapers, letters, photographs, and maps when we think of primary sources. In studying psychology, we also rely on primary sources, but in this case, our primary sources are ones that appear in scholarly or academic journals in the field. These primary sources are journal articles, which are the first-hand accounts of a research study written by the researchers who did the study. For example, you may have heard of the Stanford Prison Experiment, a famous study where researchers recruited college students to recreate conditions in a prison setting. The researchers wrote up the study and published it in a scholarly journal. There you can read the original report, which is considered the primary source. There have also been books written about the Stanford Prison Experiment by others, as well as magazine articles and even a Hollywood film. Secondary sources such as these are not the first-hand accounts like primary sources, but they may provide helpful summary, analysis, and historical context. Another type of secondary source is the literature review, which is usually a journal article that summarizes the research done by others in a particular area. Literature reviews can not only help you get an overview of the research that's been done, but they also provide a list of the original studies or primary sources. Always check with your instructor to determine what types of resources are required for a particular assignment. In many psychology courses, you will be asked to find journal articles so that you get your information from the original research report, as opposed to someone else's later interpretation of it. Besides containing original research studies, another reason why you'll want to rely more on scholarly journals than popular magazines and newspapers in your psychology courses is that many scholarly journals are peer-reviewed. This means that their articles have been evaluated by outside experts or peers before they are accepted for publication. This process helps to produce a high level of quality that makes these journals valuable to researchers and students. To locate these scholarly journals, let's begin at the library homepage at library.webster.edu. Then click on the blue Research Guides button in the middle of your screen. Click on Psychology to the right under Social Sciences. Here on the screen is the home page of the Research Guide for Psychology. Along the left, you see a series of blue tabs under which you'll find information on finding books, articles, and other materials. Further down the page on the left, you'll find my contact information should you need assistance. To the right, you'll find a list of quick links to important sources of information. The primary resource for psychology is the Psych Info Database, produced by the American Psychological Association. This database covers a variety of journals and other materials on all aspects of psychology, psychiatry, and counseling. Next, the Diagnostic and Statistical Manual of Mental Disorders, or DSM, is a well-known resource for definitions, classification, and treatment of mental disorders. The next four databases are good complements to the PsycINFO database. Let's click the link to PsycINFO to do a search. You will need to log in to access any of our databases. When you get to the PsycINFO opening screen, you'll see some search boxes at the top in which you'll type in your topic. It's best to use single words or brief phrases as opposed to complete sentences in these boxes. Let's say we want to find research on how playing video games impacts college students. You might ask yourself, who am I interested in? In this case, it's college students. Okay, we're looking at college students. What about them? What's the problem or issue we want to focus on as regards college students? In this case, it's video games. So in the PsycINFO database, I type the phrase college students in the first search box, and in the second box, I type video games. Notice the word and that appears at the left between each search box. This tells the computer to combine what is in each box. In this example, the computer will look for articles that mention both college students and video games. If you scroll down the screen from the search boxes, you will usually see a number of options for further limiting or customizing your search. I recommend that you only use a few because the more limits you put on your search, the fewer the articles you're going to find. Notice the publication type limit on the left. This gives you the option to select peer-reviewed journal. Use this option when you want to find articles from this type of journal. Be careful when using the linked full text option at the top left, which limits your retrieval to just those articles with full text linked directly from this database. Setting this limit is fine when you just need a couple of articles, but shouldn't be used when you're doing a large project and trying to do a comprehensive search. Later, we'll see how to request articles you find in your search that don't come with the full text. If you decide not to set any limits before starting your search, you can always set them later after you do a search and get your results. Limit options will appear on the left side of the screen in many of our databases. Here's a record for our journal article retrieved by our search. Notice the subjects area circled in red. Here you may be able to find alternative search terms, such as computer games, to add to your search. The list of subject terms used by the PsycINFO database is known as the Thesaurus. You may access it by clicking the link at the top of the page. Searching the Thesaurus directly is another good way to find useful, related subject terms. Let's return to the opening search screen. In the second search box, you see that I've added computer games to the box. Using the word or tells the computer that I would like articles that mention either video games or computer games or both. Giving the computer another search term to look for usually increases your search results. Once you do a search and get your results, you may be interested in obtaining the actual articles for your project. A database may have a direct link to the full text of the article. In other cases, you'll see the article linker message. You would need to click the article linker link to find out how to obtain a copy of this particular article. In this example, the article is not available online, but is available from the Webster University Library here on the home campus. On the left side of the screen, you see information indicating specific locations in the building where you can find this journal. If you're in the St. Louis area, you may come to the library and photocopy or scan the article. It will be found on the lower level of the building. On the right side of the page, you'll see a Request It Here option for students and faculty at extended and international campuses or in online programs. We'll see in a second what happens when you click the Request It Here button. Here's an example of a journal that we don't have any access to. You would need to press the blue Request It Here button to send in a request for the article. In both of the last two examples, clicking the Request It Here button will take you to our Journal Request software. Here you see that the software transfers the information about the article you want into its request form. You would then submit the request right from the screen. Note that the first time you use this service, the software will ask you to register, which takes only a few seconds. We will order the article for you and send you an email when it's available. A link will allow you to log in to our Journal Request software and retrieve your article. You'll click the Electronically Received Articles link to the left under View to go to a page where you'll see the article you requested. Note that most articles come within 2 to 3 business days, Monday through Friday. Make sure you watch for our email and then go in and retrieve your article once you've been notified that it's available. We only keep articles for 30 days before we delete them. The library pays all costs for this service, so no additional charges are passed on to current students, faculty, and staff. If you decide to cite an article in your paper or project, you'll need to do so using APA style, developed by the American Psychological Association. Many library databases have information that will help you format the reference correctly. In the PsycINFO database, click the article title to go to the detailed record for that article. Then click the Cite link on the right of the screen. Clicking Cite will open a citation format window, and you'll see how to format the citation for your article using various bibliographic styles. Scroll down until you see the APA example. It's important to note that sometimes the database citation can have mistakes. It's fine to copy and paste the reference into your notes or your paper, but make sure you go through and correct any mistakes before submitting your work. On the Psychology Research Guide, there is an APA Style tab in the left column. On that page, you'll find information about APA Style. Let's end by discussing how to get assistance as you work on your assignment. To get help from a librarian, contact me or click on the blue Contact a Librarian button in the middle of the screen. On the left, you'll see ways that you can contact a Webster University librarian. Be sure to use the toll-free 800 number or email if you're outside of the St. Louis area. Note that our chat service is available 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, except for selected U.S. holidays. Thank you for spending time with me today. Please feel free to contact me if you have any questions about this presentation or need assistance with your psychology assignment.